Hello engineers, welcome back to Engineering Design Simplified. If you want to learn more about how to analyze mechanisms using analytical method, please subscribe to my channel. In this video, I am going to discuss inclined inline slider crank mechanism position and displacement analysis using analytical method. Here is a typical inline slider crank mechanism whose fixed link is horizontal. But in today's video, I am going to discuss a mechanism whose fixed link is at an angle theta 4 from x-axis, and that is angle is between 0 to 90 degrees, any angle between 0 to 90 degrees. So in this picture, you can see L4 fixed link is at an angle theta 4 from horizontal, L2 crank is at an angle theta 2 from horizontal. Similarly, L3 coupler is at an angle theta 3 from horizontal. So in the next slides, let us see how to derive equations using analytical method. In this picture, you can see that fixed link L4 is at an angle theta 4 from horizontal, crank is at an angle theta 2 from horizontal. So this angle we consider theta 2 prime. So theta 2 prime can be written as theta 2 minus theta 4. Similarly, this angle, coupler angle is theta 3. This angle we consider theta 3 prime. So from this picture, theta 3 plus theta 3 prime equal to theta 4. But theta 3 prime we have considered negative because it is clockwise. So we can write theta 3 equal to theta 4 plus theta 3 prime. Now let us derive equations along x prime and y prime axis. So displacements along x prime can be written as L2 cos theta 2 prime plus L3 cos minus theta 3 prime equal to L4. So minus cos theta 3 prime, cos minus theta 3 prime can be cos theta 3 prime positive. So from this we can write L4 equal to L2 cos theta 2 prime plus L3 cos theta 3 prime. Let us call that equation 1. Similarly, displacements along y prime axis can be written as L2 sin theta 2 prime equal to L3 sin minus theta 3 prime. So sin minus theta 3 prime will become minus sin theta 3 prime. So this equation will become L2 sin theta 2 prime equal to minus L3 sin theta 3 prime. So sin theta 3 prime equal to minus L2 by L3 sin theta 2 prime. So in the previous slide, we have written sin theta 3 prime equal to minus L2 by L3 sin theta 2 prime. We know that theta 3 prime equal to theta 3 minus theta 4 and theta 2 prime equal to theta 2 minus theta 4 from previous slides. So by substituting this in the above equation, we get sin theta 3 minus theta 4 equal to minus L2 by L3 sin theta 2 minus theta 4. So theta 3 will become theta 4 plus sin inverse minus L2 by L3 sin theta 2 minus theta 4. This is the equation for coupler angle. So similarly, from equation 1 from previous slides, L4 equal to L2 cos theta 2 minus theta 4 plus L3 cos theta 3 minus theta 4. Here we have substituted for theta 2 prime and theta 3 prime. So this is the equation for slider position. After having derived equations for coupler angle and slider position, now in this slide, let us discuss how to derive equations for maximum and minimum position of the slider and slider displacement. So L4 max can be written as L2 plus L3. That will occur when theta 2 equal to theta 4. That is, theta 2 is equal to theta 4, that crank is falling on this line. So similarly, L4 minimum will occur, L4 minimum equal to L3 minus L2. That will occur when theta 2 equal to theta 4 plus pi, 180 degrees. So when theta 2 will become theta 4 plus pi. So this is this position. So similarly, slider displacement, if you want to consider the farthermost point is farthermost slider position is 0, then in that case slider displacement can be written as L4 max minus L4 theta 2. So L4 theta 2 is position of the slider at any given angle theta 2. Similarly, if you want to consider the nearest slider position is 0, then displacement can be written as delta L4 equal to L4 theta 2 minus L4 minimum. So L4 theta 2, again it is the position of the slider at any given angle theta 2. After having derived all the necessary equations, now let us solve a problem using Microsoft Excel. In this problem, we have considered L2 equal to 480 millimeter, L3 equal to 1600 millimeter, theta 4 is 30 degrees. So this column is a crank angle from 0 to 360 at an interval of 30 degrees. So this is a crank angle theta 2 prime, and this column is a coupler angle theta 3 prime, and this column is a coupler angle theta 3. So similarly, this column is a L4 slider position, and this column is the slider displacement. So here we have considered farthermost point of the slider, farthermost position of the slider is 0, that will occur when theta 2 equal to 30 degrees, that is equal to theta 4. That means this crank is falling on this line. So at that position, we have considered that 0 displacement, and as crank moves, then slider is going to come down towards this center of this crank. So the displacement increases. In the coming slides, let us discuss graphs. In this graph, we have plotted crank angle versus coupler angle. Crank angle on the horizontal 0 to 360 and coupler angle on the vertical. So at 120 degrees of crank angle, we can see coupler angle is minimum. Similarly, at 300 degrees of crank angle, coupler angle is maximum. In this graph, we have plotted crank angle versus slider position. Crank angle along horizontal axis and slider position along vertical axis. At 30 degrees, you can see the slider position is maximum. That means crank is falling on this line, theta 2 equal to theta 4. So similarly, at 210 degrees, we can see slider position is the minimum. That will happen when crank angle is theta 4 plus 180 degrees. That means this position. In this graph, we have plotted crank angle versus slider displacement. So here we have considered at farthermost position of the slider is displacement is 0. At farthermost position of the slider, displacement is 0. So as the crank moves, then slider also moves down towards the center of this crank. So displacement will occur. So in this graph, you can see at 30 degrees, that means when theta 2 equal to theta 4, that is farthermost position of the slider, displacement is 0. As the crank turns at 210 degrees, we can see displacement is maximum. That means when theta 2 equal to theta 4 plus 180 degrees, this position, that is at the bottommost position of the slider or nearest position of the slider, we consider that is a maximum displacement. That's all for today's video. If you like this content, please like, share and subscribe. Thanks for watching.